Kind of snuck up on you a little bit, didn't we there? Good evening, everybody. It's nice to be here tonight as we get set to crown the 2010 Full Throttle Champions. And great to have a DJ with me on stage, known to a lot of you people. Ladies and gentlemen, how about a nice round of applause, Johnny Knight. I'm in Los Angeles working with a guy named Johnny Knight. That's your real name, right?
Yes. Yes, yeah. It is.
And I'm Tommy Testosterone, too, so we'd like to just fucking call him Johnny Knight. You know, don't quit your day job, Johnny. We're going to have a great time tonight, though, with Johnny on stage here tonight. I don't know about you, but I'm preparing to get down. Give me some get down music, Johnny. No, not that music, Johnny. That's good. Of course, at my age, getting down's not the problem. It's getting back up that troubles me, so I'm worried about that. But I know you people are thinking, you spend all this money to buy a ticket to dress up, you're going to watch a 64-year-old white guy dance. This is going to be a great night, isn't it? NHRA really knows how to throw a party, don't we? But it's going to be a great night tonight, a historic night. And a lot of you folks may not know, but this venue that we are in has a great part of history. They actually talked about tearing it down a couple of years ago, but it is such a great part of history. Over 50 years ago, Dwight Eisenhower had the first presidential news conference away from the White House at this hotel. And a couple years after that, John Kennedy held his first California political rally at this hotel. And in recent years, the longest acceptance speech in the history of drag racing was given right here at this hotel. And earlier today, the biggest price ever charged for a club sandwich happened right here at this hotel earlier today. So there's a lot of history right here, and we hope you all enjoy it. I got to tell you, that club sandwich is so expensive, even Johnny Gray thought it was expensive. And if Johnny Gray's complaining about the money, you know that it's a lot of money. But is that the Johnny Gray table over there? Well, we're glad to have all you folks here tonight. You may notice, though, around a couple of the tables, there are some empty seats. A couple of our friends left tickets for some guests who couldn't make it here tonight for a variety of reasons. Warren Johnson left some tickets for Ray Charles. He couldn't make it here. He's out hanging out with Jim Head somewhere. John Force left tickets for a couple of his good friends, but Glenn Beck and Sean Hannity couldn't show up either tonight, so they're appearing on the O'Reilly Factor somewhere here in town. Ellie Tonglet left tickets for his friends, but when they found out that they weren't old enough to drink, they figured they might as well just stay home. Besides, the thought of watching me dance on stage was more than they could handle, so there's a couple of extra tables there, too. So, and some of our Safety Safari members couldn't be here tonight either because they're still cleaning up from Saturday at Las Vegas. Okay? Hey. Those things happen. But a lot of drivers will be honored here tonight. A lot of them had good years, but as I mentioned already, none of them had as good a year as Johnny Gray did. Johnny Gray had a great season. He and his son both finished in the top 10, and Shane won a race yesterday. I think that deserves a round of applause for him. But that wasn't what made it a good year for Johnny. You may have heard that he sold his business for a rather large sum of money. In fact, it's such a good deal for Johnny. He said that tonight, drinks are on him. So that's a good thing for Johnny. Actually, he sold it for so much, he could probably have new cars for everybody tonight. Now, that'd be a great deal. So, Johnny, step up a little bit there, will you? That's enough to make me dance, getting a free car there. But as all the guys here, most of the fellas that are here tonight, of course, went over to the world-famous Carducci's for their tuxedos tonight. How many bought their tuxes at Carducci's? Let's see a show of hands. Rented, I'm sorry. It's a great night. I know I'm wearing the tux and tails tonight, and I know I look like the butler. And people throw me their keys to park their cars, but, you know, the girls don't understand this, but we went over to Carducci's this year, and he had his daughter there helping out a lot of the guys that went in and get tuxes, and it's just a guy kind of thing. You know, you walked in there, and she could look at you and say you'd look good in a Speedo and a pith helmet, and you'd have bought it, you know, so she could have said, Bob, you need to wear a black tux, a black shirt, and a green tie, and I'd have just said, how much? Or a black shirt and a red tux, and I'd have said, how much? I don't want to point any fingers out to those that are here tonight, but we're just an easy touch, girls. What can I say? For example, for the girls, how many women are here are wearing a rented dress? One hand. See? So it's a whole different thing. You women just don't understand this. But I want to tell you, that there are a lot of great-looking women here tonight, and they're dressed up for a very special cause. A lot of the women have gotten together and are creating a calendar that's called the Housewives of NHRA. No, this is the truth. This is the truth. Two of the wives are trying to raise some money for a friend of theirs who was afflicted with cancer. Some of the ladies today went out, actually posed for the calendar earlier today, and the calendars will be available for sale. It's 20 bucks. They've done a great job. And I think most of the women are here. So those who pose tonight, please stand up. Let's acknowledge you. It's a great night. I know Allie Dixon, her sister, Alan Johnson's wife. And it's all for a great cause, and we really appreciate it. Thank you very much, because this is a great, caring community. I know my wife was supposed to be on the calendar. Well, you guys are killing me. But she went to the airport, and on the way here, they told her she had to go through one of those full-body scans, and she refused, and she went home. You know, I, on the other hand, coming out, I volunteered for a full-body scan, and the TSA people refused, and they went home, so... But we appreciate all the ladies doing it. It's a wonderful thing. I know Kim Anderson's part of it tonight. You look wonderful as always. I talked to Greg. Greg said the way his wife spends money when he wins the championship, it's cheaper for him to finish in second place. So that's what he said. But for all the ladies that took part in that, thank you. It's a wonderful thing. We really do appreciate it. I think the calendars are 20 bucks, and it's a nice thing. We hope you all raise money, a lot of money for charity, because it's just great. We appreciate it. One more time. Very nice for the ladies there. So. And we are honoring a lot of our champions here tonight. For those of you that don't get any money tonight, don't forget Johnny Gray will be in the back buying drinks for everybody at the end of the night. Bars open till midnight, so just see Johnny and mention my name, okay? So it was another great year for us, another great season. Some races ran a little late. Some had a little too much rain. Some had a little too much oil. But overall, it was a great year for us. And we're going to crown the champions tonight. And a lot of those championships weren't decided until yesterday. Very dramatic final day of the season. That really did epitomize what the full throttle drag racing season is all about. So we're looking forward to having a very good night tonight. Because the champions really earned the right to come up here on stage tonight, we want to tell you a couple of things. Enjoy yourself, come up on stage, have some fun, and feel free to take as long as you want with your acceptance speeches. All right, I lied about that last part, but the rest of it's okay. So. We're going to have a nice night tonight. One thing I would like to do, I'd like to acknowledge a special member of the NHRA Board of Directors, Mr. Dallas Gardner, is here with us tonight. Dallas, where's Dallas? Always great to have him here with us, right there. Thank you very much, Dallas. Now we're going to give out some of our championship awards here tonight. You know, for the past few years, we've had some wild cars roaming around the pits at the NHRA drag races and selected national events. They had wacky paint jobs and crazy names, and they were unpredictable on the track, and the fans just absolutely loved them. They traced their roots back to a lot of small tracks in the Southeast, and now they're running on the biggest stage in drag racing, the NHRA drag racing tracks. They've been called a lot of things, but this year they're called the Get Screened America Pro Mod Drag Racing Series. And right now, join me in welcoming the man who made this all possible, Mr. Roger Burgess. Nice to see you, Roger. And in 2010, we were very fortunate to watch these wild and wacky Pro Mod cars run across the country, and we crowned a champion. Now, this man had previously had great success at the NHRA races, winning some of the biggest races in history, including the Mack Tools U.S. Nationals. This year, he took his Chevrolet to wins in St. Louis and Englishtown and Bristol, and for that, he is the 2010 champion. So I am proud to introduce the first Get Screened America Pro Mod Drag Racing Series champion, Mr. Von Smith. Great job, Von. Congratulations. Mr. Roger Burgess and Von Smith, ladies and gentlemen, of the Get Screened America Pro Mod Series. Once again this year, the racers who competed in the Lucas Oil Drag Racing Series at tracks across the country provided drag racing fans with some fantastic action. Thousands of racers battled it out for the championship, and a couple of them were not decided until yesterday at Pomona. Before we meet the champions right now, how about a nice round of applause for a gentleman that means so much to us in all forms of drag racing, Mr. Forrest Lucas. Let's see you, Forrest. And now the 2010 Lucas Oil World Champions. This man won a record-tying fifth consecutive title in Top Alcohol Dragster. The driver of the Rizlone Dragster, Mr. Bill Reichert. This driver had a new look at the start of the season, but the same old results at the end of the year. He is a record 14-time NHRA Top Alcohol Dragster champion, the great Frank Manzo. This driver won his first series championship, and he did it in style by posting the biggest points total in the class history. The 2010 competition eliminator, Lucas Oil World Champ, Al Ackerman. The Superstock title was not decided until the final week of the year at Pomona, and this third generation driver won his first Lucas Oil World Championship. He is the Superstock Champion of the World, Fly-In Ryan McClanahan. This young man won the season-opening Winter Nationals and led the points for most of the season. Another first-time winner, the stock eliminator, Lucas Oil World Champion, Brad Burton. This driver parlayed a great late-season charge into his third world title. He claimed the ultra-competitive Supercomp Lucas Oil World Championship, Gary Stinnett. And finally, the 990 class champion, also known as the Lucas Oil Super Gas World Champion, Mr. David Tatum III. One more time, ladies and gentlemen, a nice round of applause for the 2010 Lucas Oil World Champion. You know, nothing says drag racing like the words full throttle. That's how our racers approach every run down the track. And as the expression goes, you either go full throttle or go home. One of the most familiar figures at the races wearing a full throttle shirt is the director of motorsports for Coca-Cola North America, a great friend of all of ours, racers and fans alike, Mr. Ben Reiling.
Good evening. Thanks, Bob. Thank you very much for the kind words. I appreciate it. You know, I'm honored to be here this evening to represent the Coca-Cola Company, you know, our brand Full Throttle Energy Drink. This is our ninth year that the Coca-Cola system has been a part of this great sport. We have had the privilege of partnering with the NHRA. And on the eve of our 10th year of this partnership, I would like to extend our gratitude, our appreciation, especially to celebrate with you all who have been a privilege to work with through the years. A couple of groups I would like to begin thanking. First, coming off the recent Veterans Day celebration, and our men and women who continue to bravely defend our freedom, your sacrifices are what allow us to go racing. So for those of you in the room tonight, if you're a veteran, thank you very much. For the people who will see this beyond, thank you. Yeah. Thank you very much for what you do and what you continue to do. You know, second is the NHRA fans. You know, we all recognize it's difficult times, but you, the fan out there, you continue to shine, and you're the envy of many leagues. You're passionate, you're loyal, you're supporting your teams and their sponsors. And it's because of you, Full Throttle, and the other sponsors that are here tonight and those across the country are part of this great sport. Third, I want to thank the Safety Safari crew. You know, countless hours of dedication to ensure quality conditions for each class of racing, from sunup to well past sundown. We've seen them out there. And being there in time of need to be a friendly face and voice. Thank you very much for what you do. I'd like to thank the members of the NHRA board who are here tonight and those who cannot make it with us tonight. Tom Compton, your team, and the entire team at the NHRA, thank you for everything that you do and your support of working with the Coca-Cola Company in Full Throttle. Our track operators who are here tonight, I had a chance to talk to several of them yesterday. Thank you very much for what you continue to do for this sport, continue to making it a great activity, a great experience for the fan base. Thanks to our friends at ESPN, taking this wonderful sport and putting it through to the viewers out there. Your dedication and support is very much appreciated. And it's certainly, last but not least, the team owners, the drivers, and the crew members. A lot of hard work, a lot of passion, a lot of energy goes into doing what you're able to put together out there every week for our fans. So thanks you all for your partnership. You know, we gather here tonight, and this is all about the champions. But in order to be a champion, you have to beat the best. To all the teams who put up the good fight and competed for Wally, good work, and thanks for your participation. To the 2010 NHRA Full Throttle Champions, we have the youngest ever champion, and we have three past champions returning to hold the ultimate Wally at season end. Ellie, Greg, John, Larry, thanks to you and your teams for a great season. It goes without saying, each of you faced personal and professional obstacles along the way. Maintaining a perspective on what really matters, and at the same time, the determination and commitment to give it your all for a Full Throttle championship is a true measure of a champion. Full Throttle Energy Drink looks forward to celebrating with all of you tonight. You know, as I mentioned earlier, Coca-Cola's relationship with the NHRA enters its 10th year in 2011. So we are challenging ourselves to start the next decade of this relationship with as much enthusiasm we did back on December 3rd, 2001, when we officially announced this partnership. Now, while this is something to be excited about, Coca-Cola also looks forward to being part of the 60th season, continuing the vision of Wally Parks and honoring all those that helped shape what all of us now steward, the National Hot Rod Association. Coca-Cola also remembers Dick Wells tonight, his friendship and time to help me understand the heritage and the intricacies of the NHRA and all of its racing is not forgotten. So until we light them up next February, may you all have a wonderful night and a rewarding off season. God bless you all. Thank you very much.